Inflation in Australia is already outstripping predictions in the budget, now set to hit 8% this year. The boss of the Reserve Bank says more pain and rate rises are coming, but insists the price of doing nothing would be much higher.
In an Adelaide childcare, the Prime Minister working with animals and children.
Honey's demolishing this week.
Risky business, but a warning, these are very risky times.
Inflation's now expected to peak at around about 8% by the end of the year.
That's now higher than predicted in the budget just 8 days ago.
We know that inflation limits our aspirations. It erodes the purchasing power of take-home pay. It reduces the value of hard-earned savings.
Tonight, new figures from the ABS show working Australians have been hit hardest, with living costs up 2.6% last quarter alone. Self-funded retirees are up 1.9%, but pensioners and those on welfare are still seeing costs rise in line with the national inflation rate.
These Australians will be making tough decisions this Christmas because of a government that doesn't have a plan.
Interest rates will need to go higher still. We need to bring inflation back to target.
The Reserve Bank boss with an ominous cost of living warning about the cost of doing nothing.
If this were to happen, the evil of inflation would be with us for longer, and the eventual increase in interest rates needed to bring inflation down would be even larger.
Now, it would have been easier and no doubt more popular to splash borrowed cash on an expansionary cost of living response.
And despite these struggles across the community, both the Treasurer and Reserve Bank Governor say that subsidies or cash payments would likely make things worse.
It'll get a little bit harder before it gets easier, but it will get easier. The inflation fight won't end as soon as we want it to, but it will end.
And Nine's political editor Charles Croucher is with me in the studio tonight. Charles, a rare appearance from Philip Lowe. What else did he have to say?
Pete, Philip Lowe joined Jim Chalmers in calling inflation a dragon we need to slay, but it is energy prices that is feeding that dragon. Today, the Treasurer revealed rising power prices will cost the budget $3 billion over the next 2 years as pensions and welfare payments rise to meet that inflation. Power price rises hit everyone, but they're particularly painful for businesses, for working families, and self-funded retirees. For while some can escape the pain from interest rates, no one escapes electricity prices, Pete, including the Prime Minister and the Treasurer.
Charles, thank you. Well, three more big banks are passing on the RBA's interest rate hike, with the Commonwealth, Westpac and Macquarie announcing they'll lift variable home loans by 0.25%. Yesterday, the official cash rate was raised from 2.6% to 2.85%. The NAB was the first to pass it on.